Within Fortis, we've got a couple reports that you can run. We know the data is yours and you need to be able to search for it and filter on it and find the exact pieces that you need, and we want to make that happen quickly. So there's a few different reports that you can run. First, within the patient's profile, it's very easy. You can just either click on View All Transactions or click the Transactions tab, and it's going to bring up all the transactions for this patient. Again, you can just start filtering by days or any of the fields up here, and it will just start filtering for on those for you. If you want to look at transactions at the office level, we're going to click the Reports button, and we'll go to the Transaction Report first. This is going to pull transaction level detail. By default, when you come in here, it's going to have all of today's transactions. You can just select the transaction date dropdown and filter on any of these. If you want a custom date range, so you want to look at a certain specific date range, you can come in here and customize that as well. You can filter by any of these dropdowns on the top. So, you know, most of these are self-explanatory, like status, approved, declined, reoccurring, yes, no. Account vault is whether the card was stored or not. So this would be a stored card that you would be running it from. So the instance is, was it a stored account or was it a swiped account? And so that's really the difference there. The next report that we have is the transaction summary report. So this is going to give you a daily summary. You can look at this report by date or by batch, and you can quickly see what the total sales were, what the total refunds were, and what the voids were. So just at a quick daily glance, you can view all this information. And again, by any of the top filters, you can start filtering, and you can, as always, export all this data right into Excel. Transaction summary, credit card by type. This just gives you a breakdown of Visa, MasterCard, Amex, and Discover in case you need that. And again, by batch or date. There's an ACH summary report as well, so you can look at that. And there is an expiring account. So this one is used mostly for if you want to be proactive in looking at the cards that are coming up expiring that are tied to a reoccurring. So I can go reoccurring, yes, and I want cards that are expiring in 3 months. And this will give me all the cards that are tied to a reoccurring that are expiring in 3 months. So very quickly, you can be proactive about making sure you're catching cards that are expiring. The last report that we have is a reoccurrings report. In this report, you can pull up any and all reoccurrings, no matter when it was, if it was deleted or canceled or ended. So it's very easy. You can come in here and just start looking by start date, end date, next run date. You can search by contact and all that kind of information. So those are all your reports that you need. Again, as always, you know, just click the reports button and select any of the reports. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to us.